for a few hours to the a site that's just a cane paddock now, but it was a former cane cutters social club and an alleged illegal casino, which is sounds pretty intriguing. I'll tell you a bit more about it when we get down there, and we're back shortly. Well, here we are at the site. It's obviously a cane paddock at the moment. This crop here has just been cut a few weeks ago, and this is a return crop, so that means that it wasn't cultivated this year. The last season it would have been fully rotary hoed. So what the site was an old cane cutters and farmers social club. I believe from the late, well, the early 1900s at least, we found coins that have gone earlier than that, and it was demolished by the 1970s. Big old social club, and it was widely known as an illegal casino. There's all sorts of stories about the place, the trapdoor on the floor where they used to throw the money and all that sort of thing. I haven't found that trapdoor. It's a bit of a joke around here, but anyway, we've found a lot of coins here over the years. I've been coming here for a long time. The landowner's kindly given us permission to come in whenever we like. And I haven't been for a couple of years since it's been turned over, so hopefully we'll get some nice artifacts, and we often get coins out of here, early 20th century type coins, old Australian coins, occasional old English one. The upside, very easy to detect. It's easy to discipline your hunt up and down the rows. You just mark the rows as you go and up and down you go. The downside is because it's been it's an agricultural area, a lot of fertiliser has gone into it over the years, and the pennies, the halfpennies, the bronze alloy coins often aren't in real good condition. Some are, but it doesn't affect the silvers, but the pennies and halfpennies come out pretty toasted sometimes. But anyway, we'll have a bit of a hunt up and down these rows and see if we come up with some interesting old relics, and if we're really lucky, we might get a couple of coins out of the place. Like I said, I've been here on a number of occasions, but it always comes up with some surprises, because every couple of years it's cultivated and the deep stuff's tilled back to the surface. So anyway, we'll hopefully be back with a good find shortly. Well, here's our first find of the day. It was a lovely mid-tone at about 5 inches. Looks like an old, it's a lady's dress button. Looks like a 1940s, 1950s style button off her dress. I'll clean it up and see if there's any maker's name on the back. Pale blue, I'm not sure what that is. I'll have a good look at it when I get home, and I'll subtitle any information. Okay, on to the next target. It's that lovely bell tone. First coin of the day, and it's a silver coin. It's pretty exciting. This stuff, as I said, it keeps getting turned over. Look at that. Lovely sixpence. Beautiful. The way that's ringing, I'd say that's a sterling George V. I'll get a date off it now, and I'll come back to you, but look at that. She's pretty worn, but that's a beautiful old sixpence. Okay, be back with a date shortly. There she is, King George V silver. I'm pretty sure it's 1915. Can't quite read it there. Might be better on the video, actually. But I'll subtitle a date. Beautiful 1915 shilling, sixpence. That's, like I said, I've been over this site many times, and it gets rotary hoed every couple of years, and the deep stuff comes back to the top, so there you go. First coin of the day. Hopefully there's a few more to come. Okay, we'll move on to the next target. Well, here's my next find. It's a lovely little brass bell. Quite ornate, actually. I'll polish it up when I get home and see if there's any anything on it. It looks like a little Christmas bell or something. Maybe it's a dinner bell. I'm not sure. That's a nice little find. Very solid target, that one. Really ring up high. Okay, keep moving down these rows. Hope the wind's not too bad, but I've come about 5 rows since that little bell and the sixpence were 2 rows apart. It's this lovely signal. And looks like another silver coin. So we're doing it right here, 2 coins, 2 silvers. Looks like a little threepence. The way that's ringing, I would say it's a sterling threepence. An old one. Yep, definitely is. It's not a wheat threepence. Okay, beautiful little coin. I'll get a little clean over at the car with a toothbrush and a bit of water, and I'll come back with a date. So there we go, little silver threepence. Well, there she is, King George VI, sterling silver, 1922, threepence. What a beautiful little coin. Looks to be in really good condition too. That's just been a little wash with a bit of water, a gentle wash with water. and the detail is beautiful, so that's a lovely find. A bit like a Jenny Hughes hunt here in Cumbria, moving row by row, and makes it very easy to detect. It's easy to stay disciplined under these conditions. Okay, I'll move on to the next one. Hopefully it's another silver. 2 out of 2. Well, here's the third coin for the day, and it's the sentimental favourite. It's the old penny. Look at it just laying there. I haven't pulled it out of the ground yet. This one would have been, it's right down the middle of the row, so it would have just been ploughed up this last time the plough went through here, probably. I'll have to loosen the soil around it. She's really stuck in there. Might be an old one, if we're lucky. She is. Lovely old penny. Well, that's great. 3 old coins out of this place. That's pretty thin and worn. It might be fairly old. We'll do a quick clean back at the car, which I might add is about 10 metres away, just over there. And that next row was where I got that threepence at the start. So I went down towards that power pole and came back again, and then started this direction. I got a coin straight away, so that's good. All right, I'll go and clean this and get a date. Well, actually, it's not Commonwealth of Australia penny, King George V. Most of the bronze alloy coins out of here have been, well, what condition would you call it? About toasted, due to fertiliser. Doesn't affect the silver coins, but because it's been cultivated for so long, these coins don't survive too well. Actually, that's not too bad. It's a bit rough on the obverse, but the reverse isn't too bad. I'll get the date. It's probably a 19, I don't know, I can't quite read that, but I'll subtitle a date when I get home and put it on the video. Okay, that's great, 3 old coins. Well, this is an interesting little find. I think it may be part of a spur. Definitely very old. Looks like it may be off a riding boot spur. Anyway, that's a nice little relic. Get on to the next target now. We're having a bit of change of attack here, and I got another coin straight away, another penny. I'll clean that up straight away and give you a date and subtitle it. But what I've done here, in this direction here, all these rows here, you can generally see ceramics and glass shards all through it where the old place used to be, and occasional lead roofing nails. About 6 rows that way just stops. I assume that's the end of the site. Haven't found anything in that direction. But what I did here, instead of going up and down the cultivated centre row, I've gone at 90 degrees to the cultivation and into the where the plant cane, the cane's there, and it was next to this cane stool here, penny in the top of the mound. So that worked out. I'll just keep heading in that way at 90 degrees to the cultivated rows. As you can see, there's plenty of ground to cover. Righto. Well, the years haven't been kind to this poor old girl. It's just basically a disc. There are some lettering on, there's just some lettering on the outside, so I might be able to get the Monarch, and I don't hold much hope for getting a year off it, but anyway, never mind, I've saved it from oblivion. Move on to the next one. Well, that's a real mid-tone there. It's a really jumpy signal to start with, and look what I've got, another silver. I didn't get the hat trick. The pennies got in the way, but I got my third silver of the day. That is just a beautiful old shilling by the looks of it. It'll probably be a merino ram. The way that's ringing, I'd say it's a 50%, so it'll be a post 46. I'll just give it a quick clean and I'll get a date. This spot where I am now, I've actually moved outside what I earlier said was I thought the extent of the site, but I've come over, put four or five rows outside where the where I've been detecting, and I got a coin straight away, so I might be getting close to that trapdoor. Anyway, I'll give it a clean and I'll get a date. Well, there she is. Beautiful 1953 ram's head, merino ram shilling, Queen Elizabeth II. And I've actually moved along a few more rows outside the area where I believe the old casino to be. Well, the theory is that the coins won't just be cultivated deeper into the soil. They'll actually be spread by the cultivation, so they could be spread far and wide on this site. And like I said, there's plenty of country to cover. I mean, there's acres of it. I don't know how far they're going to get transported, but I'll keep looking, because there was a big old, a really big old Queenslander down the back there on the creek line. I haven't been down there today yet, but that's another spot I can hunt. So there's plenty of ground to cover, and the targets are still coming out, so we'll keep moving. Well, it looks like the Rotary Ho spreads these coins and artifacts further than I thought. Logical, I guess. I'm probably three or four rows outside where I believe the site to have ended, and I've just got another coin, and it's a penny. Yeah. It doesn't look like it's in too bad a condition compared to those other two I just got. I'll give it a quick clean and I'll get a date if I can, and I'll keep hunting these rows further out. And I'm actually picking the coins up in the tops of the mounds where it's like been cultivated up into the surface. So there you go, another penny. I'll just get a date off it. Well, there it is. It's a, once again, condition, dodgy. It's recognisable as a kangaroo this time. It's 1950 something, and it's definitely a Queen Elizabeth II on the back. So these last two coins, the shilling and this penny, may date from later use of the old place as a private residence. It's a very large, big square old Queenslander set on high stumps, with a like a centre courtyard. But I'm a bit further out now, so obviously there are outbuildings. It's in use as a farm, so you know, these coins could be on here really. This whole field's probably worth doing. Okay, move on to the next one.